Welcome. I welcome you all to the new session of the Laplace Transform. In this session, we shall be discussing about the physical significance of the Laplace Transform. So one of the significance of using the Laplace Transform is that we can evaluate the value of the integrals without solving the integrals with the rules of the integration. So let's evaluate the integral with the help of the Laplace Transforms. So we have a question that we have to find the value of the integral in which the integral is 0 to infinity t into e to the power minus 4t sine 2t into dt. So you can see here that there are three terms of the variable t, that is one is t e to the power minus 4t and the third is sine 2t. So if we wanted to solve with the rules of integration, then we would have to choose two functions and then we would have applied the Euler functions, and in one of the function we would have to choose again two functions. So it would be a very tedious process. And now let us look how to evaluate this integral with the help of Laplace Transform. So we have this integral, that is 0 to infinity t e raised to power minus 4t sine 2t into dt. Now since the limits involved here is, you can see here the limits involved is 0 to infinity and there is a term of exponential. So we can compare it with the basic definition of the Laplace Transform, where the Laplace Transform basic definition is integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt. So when we compare our question with the Laplace Transform definition, we shall see that on comparing, that exponential e to the power minus 4t can be compared with e to the power minus st. So on comparing, we can say that the s will take the value of 4 and the rest of the term which is left in the equation of the integral, that is t sine 2t, will be regarded as f of t. So what we have to do, we have to calculate the Laplace Transform in which our function will be assumed to be t sine 2t. So we shall evaluate the Laplace of t sine 2t, and in the end we shall substitute the answer and replace s by s is equal to 4. So let us see how to calculate the Laplace of t sine 2t. So Laplace of t sine 2t is nothing but the way to derive the formula for the Laplace Transform of t of ft, and we know that t of ft is calculated by minus 1 raised to power 1 single time derivative or first order derivative with respect to s, that is d by ds of the f of s, and f of s has to be calculated for the sine 2t. So it is Laplace of sine 2t, and we know that the Laplace of sine 2t is nothing but a very simple formula, that is t upon s square plus 4. So we have to derivate t upon s square plus 4, and in the end we shall substitute for s is equal to 4. So upon differentiating we get that it is plus 2 upon s square plus 4 ka whole square into 2s, which gives a resultant of 4s upon s square plus 4 ka whole square. Now we shall substitute for s is equal to 4. So on substitution we get the answer as 1/25. So you can see how easy it was to calculate the value of the integral which involved the multiplication of three terms of the variable t, and it would have a quite lengthy or a tedious method to evaluate the integral and then substituting the limits of 0 to infinity. And by using the method of Laplace Transform, we can evaluate the integral. It never matters that whether we have exponential term in the integral or not, but basically we want here that the limits of the integral should be from 0 to infinity. Because even though if the term is not including the term of e to the power minus st, we can multiply, or we can suppose that it is the e to the power of 0t. So we can substitute s is equal to 0 if the term does not contain the term of the exponential, and then we can calculate the integral by comparing it with the Laplace Transform. So But the basic definition or the basic requirement that we want for the evaluation of the integral is that the limit should be from 0 to infinity. Otherwise, we cannot evaluate using the Laplace transform. So now let's see in our next question. Question in our consideration is the evaluation of the integral from 0 to infinity e to the power minus t minus e to the power minus 4t by t into dt. So we have e to the power minus t e to the power minus 4t by t. Now we can suppose that we multiply it by e to the power 0t into e to the power minus t minus e to the power minus 4t by t into dt. So upon comparing it with the basic definition of the Laplace transform, we have the integral that is 0 to infinity e to the power minus stft dt. So when we will compare these two integrals, we shall first of all split up the integral into two parts. And in the first case, our ft would be e to the power minus t by t. And in the second case, it would be e to the power minus 4t by t. So we will solve it for two integrals. But what will be there? That e to the power minus st every time will be e to the power 0t. And we shall be substituting s is equal to 0 at the end of the result. So we have taken our ft as e to the power minus t minus e to the power minus 4t, or you can split up the integrals into two parts also. So we are basically now going to calculate the Laplace of ft by t. In the previous problem, we had solved the Laplace of t ft. Now we are going to solve the Laplace of ft by t. So now we know that the Laplace of ft by t is nothing but integral s to infinity f of s ds. So first of all, we have to calculate the f of s for the f of t. So the Laplace of e to the power minus t minus e to the power minus 4t is, you know, e to the power at. Laplace is 1 upon s minus a. So for e to the power minus t, the Laplace will be 1 upon s plus 1. And for e to the power minus 4t, the Laplace will be 1 minus, because there is a minus sign between the two exponentials. So it will be 1 upon s plus a. So we have that the Laplace of e to the power minus t minus of e to the power minus 4t by t will be nothing but the integral s to infinity f of s ds. So f for the f of s, we have to substitute this equation that we have calculated. And we substitute here. So we get the value that integral s to infinity 1 upon s plus 1 minus of 1 upon s plus 4 ds. So now we have to basically evaluate the integral. So integral 1 by s plus 1 ds is nothing but log of s plus 1, and 1 upon s plus 4 integral is log of s plus 4, and the values of the limits are from s to infinity. Now, since you can see here that the limit infinity is involved here, and if we directly substitute the value of infinity in the log value, so our answer would become undefined because the infinity term would come in the numerator itself. So to make it a definite value of the integral, we take s common from the logs, both the logs, and then we shall apply the formula of log m minus log n. So we can say here that this log of s plus 1 can be written as log s into 1 plus 1 by s, where we have taken s common from the first log term and we have taken the s common from the second log term also. Now we have applied the formula of log m minus log n, which is log of m by n, and ss gets cancelled, and you can see that the s term has now gone to the denominator. And when we apply the limits infinity and s is in the denominator, so 1 by infinity term will take the value of 0. So this can be written as log 1 minus of log of 1 plus 1 by s upon 1 plus 4 by s, where we have applied the limit and we know that 1 by s infinity will be equal to 0. So log 1 plus 0 will be 1, and in the denominator also we get log one value only. So we have log 1 and log 1 is 0. So for the log 1 value, what is there? That is 0 minus of log of s plus 1 upon s plus 4. Because now why we have again changed the value of s? Because we have to substitute the s value as 0. Because if we now substitute s value here in the denominator, again the value becomes undefined. So we have to again back calculate, and we have to again change the s in the numerator because we have to now put s equal to 0. So we have done log of s plus 1 upon log of s plus 4, which is minus log s plus 1 upon s plus 4. And now substituting the value of s is equal to 0 in the log value, we get the value of log as log 4. So in this way, we are able to calculate the result of the integral.